everybody. Welcome to the Jayda and Stitches show. It's almost Valentine's Day and we have a sweet treat for you. You know those candy hearts, those little pastel chalky things that come out this time of year and they have cute little sayings on them like, I heart you and you're cute and be mine. Well, I thought it would be fun if we made an amigurumi version of them. These are so sweet and they're so fun and they're a scrap project, so they won't take up much of your yarn, so you can whip up a whole bunch of them this evening. If you're going to give somebody a Valentine's Day card this year, you can just say it with a heart instead. They make cute dongles for your backpack and your purse, cute keychains, and just a whole pile of them in your hands. Super cute. Anyway, without further ado, let's grab our hooks, grab our yarn, head to the craft table, and make ourselves some candy hearts. Today's candy hearts are a scrap project, so you don't need very much yarn. For my heart color today, I'm using this pretty 4-ply worsted weight yarn in acrylic, nice purple color. And I've got a little bit of white, a nice contrasting color, about the same size that I can use for my lettering. I need a little bit of stuffing. I've got some chopped up t-shirt here today. You need a yarn needle, a pair of scissors, and today's hook is a 4.25 millimeter or a G6. And that's all you need. We're going to begin with a cinch circle. We're using the single crochet stitch, and into your cinch circle, you're going to work 6 single crochet. Once you have 6 single crochet, grab the short tail, cinch up your circle. We're working in the round. We're going to increase from 6 stitches to 12. So find that first single crochet you made and single crochet twice into it. You're going to work 2 single crochet into each stitch all the way around until you have 12. At the end of row 2, we have 12 stitches. We're still increasing, we're still working in the round. So we're going to work 2 single crochet into the next stitch, and then a single crochet into the next. And that's the pattern. 2 single crochet into the next stitch, single crochet into the next stitch. And when you've worked that all the way around, you'll have 18 stitches at the end of row 3. At the end of row 3, you should have 18 stitches, and now you're just going to work 2 rows of single crochet, no increasing, no decreasing. You just want 2 straight rows of single crochet, so each row will still have 18 stitches in it at the end. And how do you know you're at the end? Well, you can use that little bump, so there's where row 1 turns into row 2, that bump right there. You can use that as your start point. Base everything off of that, so you can see you've got row 1, row 2, row 3. We've started row 4, and when you get back around to that, that'll be 4 finished, and then once more, that'll be row 5. So 2 rows of single crochet, no increasing, no decreasing. That is the end of side 1. You should have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 rows. Your last single crochet should be somewhere in line with that little bump, your start point. You can close off the row with a slip stitch to the next stitch. And you can fasten off. So grab your scissors, snip a little bit of yarn, not too much. And that's that. You can weave this in if you want. You can tuck it into the inside or you can work over it later. But you can set this aside and now repeat for side 2. But when you get to the end of row 5, do not slip stitch and do not fasten off. And I'll show you what to do when we get there. Once you complete the second side, all the way up to the end of row 5, remember we're not slip stitching and we're not fastening off. Grab your first side, and like I said, you can sort of tuck this string into the inside of the heart. But there's the fasten off right there in that space. We're going to single crochet into the stitch directly next to where we fastened off. I'm trying to keep this stitch a little on the tight side. Because if we're nice and tight, we won't end up with a little gap in between.
And now is a good time to pause and find yourself a safety pin, or perhaps a paper clip, or even a stitch marker, because we're going to mark the front of our heart. All right, I just grabbed a quick safety pin, and I've just pinned it on part of a stitch right after where we left off side two. Doesn't matter where you put it, you just want it to be on this side of the heart because you want to remember where you are as you work around and around. So let's work around and around. We're going to work every single one of the 18 stitches around the first side of our heart. So you can count as you go, and that way you know for sure that you've worked all 18. I'm just about round to the back of the heart, and this is the fasten off for side one. I'm going to work my 18th stitch into that space. There we go. I'm still keeping that little tail stuffed in here. So that's 18 stitches I've worked all the way around, and now I'm going to continue onto side two. So this is the stitch we left off of. Don't use that one. Go next to it. Make sure that stitch is as tight as you can make it. You might end up with a little bit of a space, but that's okay. We're going to clean up that gap when we're done. And now you want to work each of the remaining 17 stitches, or at least all the way back around to the beginning where your safety pin or stitch marker will be. All right, I'm back around to the beginning. There is my safety pin, so I know I'm on the front side of my heart, and here is where everything gets kind of fun and eyebally from this point on. So you want to decrease at the front and the back of your heart every single row from here on out. And you always want to single crochet three stitches together. Those three stitches might change a little bit depending on what's sitting in the very middle of your heart. So I see that these two stitches are probably the middle of my heart right now. So I'm going to pick either this one or this one. I think I'll use the one that's right here. I'm going to pick up a loop in the first stitch, pick up a loop in the next stitch, which is the stitch that's sort of sitting in the middle, and pick up a loop in the stitch next to that. And then I'm going to wrap and pull back through everything on my hook. And that's three single crochet together. So single crochet three together. Now I'm going to single crochet as normal all the way around to the back of my heart, and I'm going to do the exact same thing when I get there. I'm around to the back of my heart, and I can tell because there's my safety pin, which is the front, and now I want to decrease across the back. So I'm going to do the same thing. I'm going to single crochet three stitches together. I'm going to start by finding the two that sit across the middle, grab the one just before it, pick up a loop, pick up a loop, and pick up a loop. Single crochet all three together, and then continue. Single crochet back round to the front. Back to the front. There's my safety pin that marks my front. Here are my two middle stitches, so I'm going to use the one just before it. Pick up a loop. Pick up a loop in each of those two little middle stitches, wrap, and pull through everything. That is the pattern. You're going to single crochet three together across the middle front and the middle back for every single row, and you're just going to keep doing that, and as you do, this space that you're working is going to shrink, and once it's about the size of a toonie for my Canadian friends, that's when we're going to stop. And I'll show you how big that space is, because we want to stuff it. So basically, don't let your space get too small, because it'll make it difficult to stuff. I'll see you there. Okay, things are now narrowing to a nice round circle. I can still get both of my fingers in it though, which I want to do, because I want to be able to stuff the top parts of my hearts without, or my heart, without missing any little corners or nooks or crannies. So I've got some recycled t-shirt here, and I'm just going to grab a couple pieces at a time and just sort of neatly layer or stuff it in. You can obviously use any stuffing that you want. Whatever you do, make sure that you get all of the little nooks and crannies. So make sure you use your fingers. This is another reason you want to make sure that your hole is big enough that you can get your fingers in. And you can always tuck a little bit of extra stuffing in towards the end if you're not completely satisfied. So go ahead and take a moment to stuff your heart. All right, that's about as full as I can get it right now. And I'm going to put my hook back in and continue crocheting all the way around, making sure that I single crochet three together as I come up across the front and the back. So here I am on the front, and there's my two middle stitches. So I'm going to use the one just before, and then each of those middle stitches. And it can get a little tiresome, a little trying, when you're working in a space that gets smaller and smaller and smaller, especially when you're trying to keep the stuffing from popping out. So remember to just be patient. Take your time. There's no rush here. And you're going to continue working around and around until you are almost closed up. So you might have around 6 to 8 stitches left. Doesn't have to be an exact number, but you might want to stick in a little extra stuffing. So keep that in mind as you go around. You're going to get that hole to be smaller and smaller, but you want to make sure you can stuff in a little bit of stuffing just before you close it up tight. All right, we're getting near the end here. I've put in my last little bit of stuffing. I've given it a nice squish. It's starting to really look like a heart. And I just want to close up this last little space in the bottom. So I'm going to single crochet around to the back. You can tell that's the back because this is the front here. And I'm going to just single crochet those last 3 stitches together. That's going to bring down my stitch count to, 6 or 8. Doesn't matter. What is important at this point is how big that space or that opening is. And it is tight in here, as you can see. So trying to single crochet 3 together is going to challenge you. There we go. See that small little space now? I'm going to work one more single crochet. That should probably bring me around to the back. Make sure I get the actual stitch. And now I'm going to slip stitch around the post. So I think I'll skip over that one. I'm going to pick up the post of the stitch and just slip stitch around it. Now if that closes the circle, and it does, that's really all I need to put in there. So I'm going to fasten off, but I'm going to leave a decent amount of yarn. So this is about 20 centimeters. 20 centimeters of yarn. Basically what you want is enough that you can thread it up on your yarn needle. Now it looks like a little balloon. Whee! You can take out your pins. You don't need these anymore. So out comes the safety pin or the stitch marker. And we have this sweet little heart. You can just sort of squish it a bit. Make sure all your stuffing's in the right place. Then you want to grab your yarn needle. Thread up that tail. And if you look at the top, you probably have an opening up here. And we're just going to make sure that we get that closed up so that none of our stitching or our stuffing comes out. So I'm going to take my yarn and I'm going to feed it all the way up through the body of my heart so that it comes out somewhere near the top. And if you've used the kind of stuffing that I have, it might take you a little bit. There you go. Somewhere near the top. Don't pull too tight because you don't want to pull the bottom point of your heart out. There we go. And now all you want to do is pick up some of the stitches, so pieces of the stitch, around that opening and just gently cinch around it. Pick up a few more. You're kind of going in a circle around it. Go. A few more. And what's gradually going to happen is that you're going to see that little space close up. So it'll look nice, neat, and tidy. You won't have any of your stuffing threatening to come out. There you go. And once you've got enough of it cinched shut and you feel pretty comfortable with that, you can just stick your needle through to the front or the back, doesn't matter. And then run it back and forth underneath some stitches, just like you would be weaving in any other project. Don't pull too tight. You don't want to pull anything out of alignment. So back and forth once or twice, especially if you're using sort of this acrylic stuff, because it doesn't really want to unslip. There we go. Then you can just stiff the rest of it back into the body of your heart. So just stuff it in there. And I like to stick my needle in and wave it back and forth and just watch it disappear. Now that our heart is made, we want to write a cute little saying on it. So on this one, I've got, "You are cute." I have, "Be mine." And on my purple heart today, I'm going to write, "I heart you." So pick a side that you think you like best for the writing part of your heart. Grab your contrasting yarn color and your yarn needle. Thread up a long piece. You won't need any more than, say, 90 centimeters or about 3 feet. And we're going to begin. I'm going to put my first letter here, my heart over here, and my U in the middle just below. My characters are going to be about 2 rows high, or 2 sets of stitches high. And there's a lot of eyeballing here, but that's why it's good to start with a really simple phrase so that you don't get overwhelmed and end up sort of writing off the side of your heart. I'm going to bring my yarn in from the top, and I'm going to bring it out where I want my first letter to start. So I want my first letter to be about here. Ooh, maybe up a little higher. Don't want it to crowd. Yeah. And the letter I is nice and simple, so it's nice to use an I statement. Keep a little bit of your yarn out the top because you want to be able to knot it off. I'm going to keep my finger on that. And I'm going to make a simple straight line for an eye. Before I bring my yarn out again, I want to decide where I want to start my heart. And I'm going to begin at the bottom corner. And it's a little easier to eyeball that because I want sort of it to be on the same line as my eye. So I'm going to just go across a few stitches, keeping in mind that my heart is going to be sort of a little on the fat side. So there is the letter I. Nice and simple. I'm not going to bother putting little sticks across the top and bottom of it. And now a heart. Hearts have sort of, as you can tell, a side line and then little bumps at the top. So I'm going to make my side line first and come out right across and opposite the bottom. So there's my side line. And now I want a nice little sort of bumpy top. So I'm going to bring my yarn in across the top, halfway between both those points. And this is going to allow me, you see me sort of do this when I make like a little smiling mouth or like an eye. Back through the same place, I'm going to come back out the bottom to start my other side. Don't pull too tight. You don't want to pull things out of alignment. If you feel it's a little loose, you can tug up on your last stitch made and then just tighten up gently. So there's half a heart. I'm going to do the same thing on the opposite side, so I'm going to come over here. And there's my middle. So I'm going to make a nice wide heart. Come out in the same middle point. So there's my other side. Same thing. I want to make that nice little bump. So in at the top, halfway across, that's looking good. Not too tight, I want a little bit of slack there. And back down the top. Now that's the end of my heart, so I need to figure out where I'm putting my U. I think I'm going to start it right there in that spot. So I'm going to bring my needle out there. Alright, looking good. I, heart, and you. I'm just going to use the letter because that's nice and simple, like an old-fashioned text message. Can I say that yet? Old-fashioned text message? I want my U to end up here, and I'm going to anchor it in 2 places so that I have more of a U shape and less of a V shape. So I'm going to put my hook, or I should say my needle, back through where I want it to end eventually. and come out down here where I can put my first anchor in. Remember, if you're making a U, you want to give yourself lots of slack. A little bit less. And then back through the same little space. So same hole, but I want to come across over here so I can anchor it on the other side. There you go. I think I might need a little less. So pull up on that. There. And through the same place. See, I make sure that I'm getting it in the same spot. And now I'm done. So I'm going to bring it all the way back up here to the top, which might be a bit of a fight. There we go. Remember to be easy on that last stitch. Pull things into alignment if I have to. Looks like I still need to make that a little less loose, so pull up on that one. Better to have too much stitch than too little, because you can always tighten things up. There. That looks like a U to me. Actually, it looks like it's smiling. All right. Then you can just knot your two ends together. I like to knot mine twice. Snip off any excess. And then you can grab your yarn needle. And since you brought both those ends out through the same hole, you can tuck it back into the same place. And then pull your needle back and forth and just tug those ends into the body of your heart. You are cute. I love you. And be mine. Three of my favorite Valentine sayings.
Sweethearts for your sweetheart. Nice quick little project, and you can make up a whole pile of them with whatever pretty pastel colors you've got lying around. And that's it for this week, everybody. Thank you so much for tuning in. Happy Valentine's Day. We will see you soon on the Jayda InStitches show. Until then, stay sweet, be safe, and have a crafty week. Bye, everybody.